Welcome to part 4 of my series about FFT analyzers. If you haven't seen parts 1, 2, and 3 already, go check those out first. There are links in the description below. In part 3 of this series, I mentioned that an FFT analyzer will perform and display many FFTs per second in order to give us a simulated real-time measurement. Let's look at what that means again. Here's a digitally sampled audio waveform flowing into our analyzer. Let's imagine this waveform is 1 second long. If our sample rate is 48 kHz, then this waveform contains 48,000 samples. If we set the FFT size to 16K, then each measurement performed uses about 16,000 of those samples, which span about a third of a second. You'll recall from part 3 of the series that the portion of the waveform used by the FFT is called the time window, and its length is called the time constant. So, if our time constant is a third of a second, let's break this 1 second waveform into 3 time windows, 1/3 of a second each, right? But if the analyzer only showed us a new measurement every 1/3 of a second, it would look choppy and it would be difficult to read. Rather than perform a measurement 3 times per second, most analyzers will perform a measurement at a rate closer to the frame rate of film. Rational Acoustics Smaart, for instance, works at 24 measurements per second. 24 frames per second is fast enough to look continuous to the human eye rather than looking like a bunch of still images shown in sequence. Even if our analyzer performs a new measurement every 1/24 of a second, it can still use a time constant longer than the time between measurements. Each consecutive time window will just have overlapping data. Now let's talk about averaging. In the scenario I've just described, we measure a 16,000 sample time window every 1/24 of a second, and as time passes, we only view data from the most recent measurement. When we use averaging, we're choosing to view the average of several recent measurements rather than only the single most recent one. In Smaart, there are 4 different averaging modes: off, or no averaging, FIFO, or first in, first out, integrated averaging, and infinite averaging. First in, first out uses a buffer. When the buffer is full, each new measurement replaces the oldest one in the buffer. In this example, 4 FIFO is selected. As the 5th or newest measurement enters the buffer, the first one, or the oldest one, is pushed out. Smaart has options to do this with 2, 4, 8, or 16 measurements in the buffer. When viewing a FIFO averager in Smaart, you can see that the motion of the RTA is kind of jerky as old data leaves the averaging buffer all at once. By comparison, integrated averaging looks like this. Old data decays, meaning that as time passes, the oldest data in the buffer is given less weight than the new data. As a result, the bars in the RTA fall more gradually instead of dropping suddenly like they do in FIFO mode. Infinite averaging has an infinite buffer. Old data does not decay and it stays in the buffer forever. In Smaart, there are also fast and slow averaging options. These are integrated averaging methods just like the 1 second through 10 second options, but they use the fast and slow decay times that are found in SPL meters. Fast mode has a buffer of slightly less than 1 second. That's averaging in a nutshell. It can be used in spectrum measurements and transfer function measurements, and it has benefits in both cases. I'll explain that in detail when I discuss transfer functions and coherence in later videos. One last note. When we choose to run a 16K FFT, it's not literally 16,000 samples. It's actually 16,384 samples. I just rounded that to 16,000 to simplify the explanation. If that doesn't make sense, you can find an explanation in part 3 of this video series. Thanks for watching! Please leave your suggestions, thoughts, and questions in the comments section below. If you learned something, hit the like button, and subscribe if you want to learn more. See you in the next one!